All right, we're using symbols to compare fractions. Okay. Let's look at this here. It says Ty and Luke have same size juice boxes. Okay. Ty drinks 3/8 and his of his juice, and Luke drinks 3/6 of his juice. Okay. So easiest way to do this, do a number line. It's a lot easier to make the number lines the same length than doing a box, right? Well, it actually is. So in your composition book, follow me. In your composition book, follow me. That's one number line. And here's another. Okay. 0, 1. 0, 1. The top one, 3/8. So look, just first cut in half, then half again, and then half again. And 3/8 is right here. See, because I went 1, 2, 3. Okay. The other one is 6, so just cut it into thirds, and then cut that in half, and I get 6ths. 3/6, 1, 2, 3. That's right there. And label it. And I have 3/8 and 3/6. Okay, so 3/8 and 3/6. Based on using the number line, who drinks more? This is Luke and this is Ty. Who drinks more? Who drinks more? Luke. Yeah, look how far Luke is. Okay, and then look how far Ty is. See, it's a lot easier to figure it out when you use a number line. All right. This is number one. Says Julie and Mackenzie have the same number of homework problems. Julie has done 1/3 of her homework. Mackenzie has done 1/2 of her homework. Compare the fractions using less than, greater than, or equal to. Well, first of all, let's write them out. 1/3 and 1/2. Okay. When the numerators are the same, okay, the smaller denominator is the bigger fraction. So which is the bigger fraction? 1/3 or 1/2? 1/2. So what sign of money you use? Greater than, less than, or equal to? Less than, because 1/3 is less than 1/2. Okay? I could use a number line. They're about the same size. Okay. I'm going to cut this into thirds. Okay. And here's 1/3. Okay. That's 1/3. I'm going to 1/3, sorry. And I'm going to cut this in 1/2. Okay. So here's 1/2. So yeah, based on that, here's 1/3. Here's 1/2. Based on that, yeah, 1/3 is less than 1/2. Says Dion and Rob. I'm on page 546. Dion and Rob. Okay, get the same size pack of crackers. Dion gets 3/6 of his crackers. Dion eats 3/6 of his cracker, and Bob eats 3/4 of his cracker. Okay, so let's compare that. 3/6 and 3/4. Okay, my numerators are the same. So that means the smaller denominator is the bigger fraction. So what sign am I going to use? What sign am I using? What? Less than. Okay. Again, if I did a number line, this is 6. So I'm going to cut into thirds first and then cut each third a half, in half. 1, 2, 3. That's right here. That's 3/6. I'm going to cut this in fourths, a half, and then a half. 3/4, 1, 2, 3. That's here. 3/4. And then, so look, based on that, here's 3/6. Here's 3/4. So 3/6 is less than 3/4. If I use a number line. All right. It says which fraction goes in the blank to make the comparison true. So I want a fraction that is less than 5/8 is less of, which is greater, right? Okay, is it A? Is 5/8 less than 5/8? Is 5/8 less than 4/8? Is 5 less than 4? No, it isn't. How about 5/8 less than 6/8? Last time I checked, 5 is less than 6. So the answer is C. Okay. It says Blake chose A as the correct answer. Did he get the answer? Did he get the answer? He chose this. Blake chose this. Is he right? No, because those are the same fractions. They actually would be equal. How about this one? I have to have something less than 2/8. Okay. Would it be 4/8? 2/4, sorry. No. Again, when the denominators are the same, when the numerators are the same, the smaller denominator is the bigger fraction. So this 2/4 would be more bigger. Okay. How about 4/8? No, last time I checked, 4 is greater than 2, not less than. 1/8. Yes. Yes, because 1 is less than 2. Okay. Which model can you use to compare 1/3 and 1/6? Which one do you think? Okay. Can I do A? No, because guess what? They have to be, whoops. They have to be the same length, right? Okay. Can I do C? No, because this is not 1/3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 1/6, but this is not 1/3. This is 3/6, which is a half. Can I do D? No, because both shapes are not the same length. But can I do this one? Yes, I can. This is 1/6. And this is 1/3. Plus, they are the same length. Look, they are the same length. Okay. Okay. It says write the number from the list below in each box to make it the same and true. All right, let's do that. So my numerators are the same. Okay. My denominators are the same. So I need to find a number that's less than another number. So what could go here? What? Anybody? Okay, let's go with 1. One number can go here that's less than 1. Any of those, 6, 8, 3, or 4, right? Can I do this? No, because 6 is not less than 8. 1 is not less than 8, and 3 is not less than 8, and 4 is not less than 8. Okay? Can I put 6 here? Yes, because I can put 8 right here, and 6 is less than 8. Okay? It says, look at the comparison below. Something is less than 3/4. Tyrone writes a fraction in the blank to make the comparison true. Its fraction is 3 in the numerator. Okay, so it says that it's 3 in the numerator. I'm on 348. 3 in the numerator. What fraction could he have written to show your work? So it's like this. And like that. So what number could I write right here to make that true? Yes. Any number that's higher than 4, I could put in that box. 3/5, 3/6, okay? Because we said when the numerators are the same, the smaller denominator is the bigger fraction. Yes. Like I said, any number that's greater than 4, I could put in that box as a denominator.